seems sometimes that in society, technology is seen as the cause of our problems. But at the same time, I think we have to acknowledge that if we are not willing, if we're not willing to live in a worldwide dictatorship that, for instance, regulates reproduction or who gets how much of which, if we live in a free world where it's an individual decision of how I live my life, the only solution is technology. Because if we continue as we do with the freedom that we love and the methods that we use today, we'll destroy our planet. So if we don't want to change the freedom part, we have to change the methods. And the solution is technology. Why is the laser so important for the world? First of all, it's just a fascinating tool. Part of the fascination is that the laser really only exists on Earth. The laser light, as it has been described by Albert Einstein in 1917 and then realized in 1964, is something that is truly human-made. We have seen that from telecommunication, modern telecommunication, to EUV lithography and everything in between, making sheet metal parts, welding pacemakers, making car batteries for modern e-mobility vehicles, all of this would not be possible. It would just not be possible without the laser. We just have opened the door to the possibilities of the laser, just a slight crack. And there's a huge room behind there that we still haven't explored. The most important one is, of course, EUV lithography, extreme ultraviolet light lithography. And it replaces the process of 193 nanometer lithography. So essentially, the light is that used to generate the structure on a wafer only becomes a bit shorter in wavelength. That's the whole thing. Why is this so relevant? Over the last 50 years, the world economy had a free of charge productivity driver that's called the Moore's Law. Every 2 years or so, the computing power and the storing power of semiconductors has doubled. And we all took this for granted for 50 years. And it made all of what we have more productive. So it's highly relevant for the world economy. Without it, the world as we know it, with new, more powerful iPhones every 2 years, be it necessary or not, but it's what we're used to, would have come to an end. I'm certain that the world of the future will be heavily influenced, first of all, by quantum sensors, special devices that will become very present in everyday life. It's foreseeable that our mobile devices, for instance, will have such sensors in them. And these will be sensors that will enable us to communicate with these devices in a different manner, possibly through thought, which is, of course, a very, very interesting idea. Other devices will also be made possible through quantum sensors. For instance, autonomous driving, because we will be able to build gyroscopes that are far more sensitive than what we see today. To me, the most fascinating aspects are the sensing aspects, because I can imagine them, and they're again in the sense of what's meaningful to humankind. The idea of very simplified diagnostics in medicine is really something that fascinates me. The idea that I could have an MRT in my smartphone. I know that sounds crazy, but it's at least feasible. Or at least that every doctor has an MRT that costs a few thousand euros to buy. And I can just go, and if I feel I have a sprained ankle, I just go. The second thing I find truly fascinating is that it will enable us to better understand the brain, because it will enable us to monitor thinking. And of course, it can be scary if you think about it, but from a scientific standpoint, it's absolutely fascinating. And I personally am certain that once we better understand how the human brain works, we will no longer think that singularity is near, in the sense that AI can replace the human brain. I don't think that AI will ever replace the human brain. And if we have quantum sensors, we'll understand why that won't take place. Of course, the misuse of something like that is instantly evident, how it could be misused. And these are terrible thoughts. But with every technology, that's the case. Ever since the first rock was used as a tool, it was usable both to kill a person or hurt a person or to cut meat with it. The product should have an inherent quality such as ruggedness, as also beauty, but an overriding quality that I would describe as meaning. It has to be meaningful in the sense that it has to have something good in it. And if I think, for instance, of EUV lithography, this is, of course, a totally fascinating science project. And it is also a commercially highly interesting proposition. But it's also meaningful to be at the core of the team that enables Moore's Law to continue, that enables new devices to be invented that can bring artificial intelligence to everyday life, etc. I think this is meaningful by itself. I think the greatest potential for humanity is education. If we succeed in educating not only in the sense of bringing knowledge to the people, but also bringing ethics to the people, we have a huge potential. Because in the end, I'm absolutely convinced that according to the fascinating book, Humankind, that human is kind. I think we are not evil and civilization makes us good. It's the opposite. I think we're good by nature. There's no other being in the world that can communicate like us. There's no other species that blushes, for instance, that feels shame. And in that sense, if we develop education that not only transports knowledge, but transports this message, and again, I'm an idealist probably in this sense, I see a wonderful future for us on this planet.